Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with our look at today's stock market. We're coming up to 7:30 a.m. on the East Coast, and stock index futures are flat at the moment, so not a lot of direction with 2 hours to go before the market opens. Let's start off this morning's presentation looking at the major stock market indexes that we follow. We saw a nice pop in fear yesterday. On Wednesday, we need the VIX to close below 1466 to indicate that fear is dissipating. Next target to the upside, if we take out the recent high, is 1875 on the VIX. Looking at the S&P 500 cash index, we need a close on Wednesday above 1979.65 to give us a buy signal. Don't think that's going to happen. If we take out the recent low, then look for a move down to 1906.25. Looking at the NASDAQ 100, we need a close on Wednesday above 4051.02 to give us a buy signal. Don't think that's going to happen. 3906.25 is our next mathematical target. Below that is the low from the summer low of 3845.20. That would be our next target if support at 3906.25 does not hold. Looking at the TSX, we need a close above 15,004.04 to give us a buy signal on Wednesday. Don't expect that to happen. Next target to the downside is 14,375. It's going to be no surprise to anyone that we're going to see weakness across the board here. The global Dow, emerging markets. There's the Dow 30 still trading above last week's low. There's the Russell and the ZAC starting to slip below last week's low. The Venture Exchange, of course, continuing to plunge lower, making lower lows there. Bank stocks were hit hard yesterday in the U.S., down nearly 2%, 1.64% in Canada. There's the credit card stocks down, still trading above last week's low. There's the Amex Oil and Gas Index still trading above last week's low. Canadian energy stocks slipped below last week's low, so continued weakness there. There's the XAU continuing to move lower, as did the TSX Gold Index. Semiconductors came down hard yesterday, took out last week's low. That's not very bullish for the technology sector. And there's the Dow Transports holding on to last week's low. So we'll look to see if that support breaks. Of course, anything that takes out last week's low, then we assume that we're going for the late July, early August lows, depending on what index you're looking at. Next up, let's take a look at bond prices. Starting off looking at the 30-year bond futures contract, it continued to move higher yesterday. So it still looks like money's coming out of the stock market back into the bond market. That is also true of the bond market ETFs. This is the Vanguard Total Bond Market ETF. And we're moving into an open gap here. We've traded through the bottom of the open gap. So, of course, the next logical target is the top of the open gap. So we'll have to see how bond investors feel about the market when it gets up and fills that open gap. That is also true north of the border with the XBB. It's got a big open gap there that could also potentially act as resistance on the upside. Okay, next up, let's take a look at currency prices. Tuesday was a fairly quiet day for currencies, an inside day for the US dollar with a little pullback. A little gain in the euro. The euro had an inside day. We saw a little buying in the British pound, but still trading below the lower channel line. New buy signal for the Japanese yen on Tuesday. And the Canadian dollar closed lower slightly on the day, inside day from Monday's trading action. Next up, let's take a look at commodity prices. Starting off with the PowerShares Commodity Index ETF, we had a little pullback yesterday. It was actually an inside day, so quiet trading for commodities. A little pullback for copper, still trading in the channel. A close above 36.78 would give us a buy signal on Wednesday. 117.13 for the GLD, 125.76 for the Platinum ETF, and for the SLV, inside day yesterday, we need a close above 16.81. Looking at energy prices, crude oil was down a little yesterday. So after we've broken down below the triangle that was forming, and of course we're trading below all the moving averages, which are pointing lower, we're projecting lower prices here. So that shouldn't be a surprise once you start breaking down. Once you start trading below the moving averages and the moving averages are pointing lower, you're expecting lower prices. That's also true for gasoline. For natural gas, we're still waiting to break out of the triangle here. So we have a nice triangle sloping down trend line, sloping down, and a breakout of that. And of course, we're looking for a move above the 200-day moving average. That would be bullish. But right now, we're still expecting a breakdown here and lower prices for natural gas. Last up this morning, quick look at a couple of intraday charts. Now we can see that fear was continuing to rise going into the close yesterday. So the first sign that something new is happening on Wednesday is going to be an hourly close on the VIX below 1584. At that point, we might see the S&P 500 starting to move up above 1958.59. For the NASDAQ 100, we're looking for an hourly close above 4,378. Looking at bank stocks, actually came down harder than the rest of the market yesterday. So you can see we closed at the low of the day yesterday. So we're taking a run at last week's low. The first sign something new is happening, looking at the Dow Jones U.S. Banking Index, 314.05, an hourly close above that would give us a buy signal. There's semiconductors, and they came down harder than banks yesterday. And so we're starting to trade below last week's low. Look for an hourly close above 616.01 to give us a buy signal, intraday buy signal on Wednesday. And looking at the TSX, we're getting pretty close to last week's low there. If we break that, of course, then we're going to continue to look for acceleration to the downside. On the upside, and we do have energy inventory numbers coming out this morning, so that might help the energy sector if we get positive numbers there. Looking for an hourly close above 14,739 on Wednesday to give us a new buy signal for the TSX. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Looking over my shoulder, the futures are still flat, so really no direction in the market at 7:30 a.m. on the East Coast. Have a great day, folks, and we'll be back a little later this morning to look at the NYSE 10 most actively traded stocks, and then, of course, we'll be back again on Thursday morning. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.